फिजिकल स्टेट, फिजिकल स्टेट. सो क्लोरीन इज अ गैस, क्लोरीन एंड क्लोरीन आल्सो गैसेस. ब्रोमीन इज अ ओनली लिक्विड, दैट इज अ नॉन मेटालिक लिक्विड इन द पीरियडिक टेबल. सो ओनली ब्रोमीन नॉन मेटालिक लिक्विड. And iodine, aspartate, and all solids. Solid iodine is a special. If you see, iodine is a easily sublimable solid. So the non-metallic liquid is a bromine. Non-metallic liquid in the periodic table only one element, that is a bromine. Now next to order electronegativity. If you see in this group, the top to bottom electronegativity, fluorine to iodine, decreases. Electronegativity so decreases, and fluorine is the most electronegative element in the periodic table. Most EN element of, you know, periodic table. Fluorine is the most electronegative element in the periodic table. And here metallic nature is inversely proportional to electronegativity. Electronegativity is inversely proportional to metallic nature. Electronegativity inversely proportional to metallic nature. So iodine less electronegative, less EN atom from the all halides. So it can form so easily, cations easily. Next, this is about electronegativity. Next to fourth property, ionization energy. Ionization energy means the amount of energy required to remove an electron from the valence shell in gaseous state. So ionization energy values are very high, very high, very high. So because of these are less size elements, due to least size, they are exist in the periodic table right side. So they have least size, so that's why the ionization energy values are very very high. And ionization energy values for fluorine is more than after chlorine, than after bromine, than after iodine. So iodine have least. So iodine easily forms cations. So ICl and ICl, iron cyanide, iron chloride. In this case, so iodine is plus, so here also iodine is plus. So then in molten state they conduct electricity. In molten state conduct electricity. That means they can be exist as free ions. So I plus Cl minus. So iodine plus iodine cation is exist because of it have less electronegativity and less ionization energy. So the tendency to form cations also decreases top to bottom. The tendency to form cations increases because electronegativity, ionization energy, electronegativity is decreases. So the tendency to form cation formation increases. So iodine easily forms cation in these elements. So they can be exist as ICl, ICn in these these cations, iron plus exist. So in molten state they can conduct the electricity. Next to electron affinity means the amount of energy released when an electron is added to the gaseous valence shell of the atom, then forms X minus. The energy released is called electron affinity. So the electron affinity means the amount of energy released when an electron is added to the gaseous valence shell of the neutral atom is called electron affinity. The electron affinity values among the all group elements, these elements have high electron affinity. Among the all group elements, these halides have more electron affinity values, because the liberated energy is more, and they get more stable after gaining electron. They get more stable, so that's why they can release more energy, because get more stability. If gain one electron, X minus, it is more stable, so more energy released. The energy released also more, so that is electron affinity values also more. If you see order of electron affinity values, fluorine, first chlorine, then after chlorine, then after bromine, then after pyrimidine. Here fluorine have less electron affinity than expected. So generally top to bottom electron affinity values decreases, but here fluorine is exception, because due to least size, due to less size, electronic repulsions with the already existed electron pairs. Less size and strong electronic repulsions and strong electronic repulsions. Electronic repulsions by incoming electron, because here in the case of fluorine, there are already 7 electrons in small size. If you add one electron, again the repulsions are exist, so undergo destabilization. So that's why less energy releases in the case of fluorine. So the electron affinity of fluorine is less than the chlorine, because due to small size of fluorine, there are already 7 electrons exist in the fluorine. If you add one more electron, the strong electronic repulsions are exist between incoming electron and already existed electron. Due to small size, the electrons are overall spread, so repulsions exist. So least stress are stable. So that's why the energy released in the case of fluorine is less compared to chlorine. Now, so next to bonding and valency. So these group elements have 7 electrons in the valency shell. So if they gain one electron additionally, they get 8 electrons. 8 electrons mean after 2 get. So in the valency shell, these elements have 7 electrons. If they gain one electron, they go to form octet role, so get a stable. So that's why always, most of the cases, these elements form so valency one. So show so usual valency. Usual valency is one. And also the maximum valency. These elements also so maximum valency is equal to group number. Maximum valency equal to group number, that is 7. They can also form so 7 bonds like chlorine, iodine. And if you see fluorine, the unique valency is 1. Fluorine among the periodic table, only one fluorine element can show so only one unique valency, that is 1. It can only form so one bond only. It can form so only one bond only. Next. Here you see bonding. So valency. Next to bonding, bond energy. Bond energy, if you compare. The bond energy top to bottom, the attractive forces, bond length increases. Bond length is inversely proportional to bond energy. Bond energy. Here, in the case of, so like that, if you see, therefore, the bond energy is top to bottom decreases. Bond energies top to bottom, that means fluorine to iodine decreases, but small exception, bond energy, if you see order of bond energy. Here fluorine have more bond energy than bromine, then after fluorine, then after iodine. Again fluorine is an exception because of due to electronic repulsion spread between two fluorine atoms. This is fluorine atom, this is fluorine atom. There are three lone pairs present on the each fluorine atom. There are three lone pairs are present. So between adjacent fluorine atoms, bonded fluorine atoms, the repulsions between lone pairs, between lone pairs of bonded atoms. So they have, fluorine have least bond energy compared to expected because to small size and small bond length, only 1.44 angstroms only present between two fluorine atoms, the bond length. So due to small bond length and there are three lone pairs are existing, they will be strongly repel each other, so bond is easily break, so bond energy is less. Next to here oxidation states. So generally we can show so oxidation states. So you see -1 they can show, +1 they can show, +3, +5, and +7. Come on, +7 oxidation states they can show. Here chlorine and bromine also shows. Also shows then all elements except fluorine, all elements can show these all oxidation state. Fluorine bromine also shows so +4, +6 oxidation state. In oxides and oxy acids, fluorine and bromine also shows +4, +6. So along with this, -1, +1, +3, +5, +7 oxidation states. The unique oxidation state of fluorine unique oxidation state is -1. Fluorine never shows +1 and other oxidation states.
because absence of d orbitals, because absence of d orbitals, absence of d orbitals, there is no d orbitals in the case of fluorine. So its valency also only one, more than valency fluorine never shows because of absence of d orbitals, and also fluorine shows only minus one oxidation state. It will not show other oxidation states because of d orbitals are not exist for a fluorine atom. Next, you know, other oxidation states, different